Hello, sweet tooth here. Hope our day is going well. Let's play some more Metroid Prime. If the game works. Back to the Chozo Ruins. Don't know if it's just me, but when it zooms in on her when she's in a save point, it looks like she's cross-eyed. I don't know if that's just me. Tone it down just a little. So I guess I'm going this way. Roots originate over walls. No decomposition detected. Host plant appears to thrive on toxic water. Okay, now it's gonna provide me with direction. Let's see. Alright, so I gotta go that direction. Like, I could go this direction, but because I don't have enough power-ups, probably not gonna make a difference. Especially if I don't have Spider Ball. I usually hold L when I jump, because you can actually control your jump entirely with it. It's pretty cool. It sucks without the double jump. I realized too late when I was falling. It was kind of hard to, like, figure out where you're jumping without looking down. Tells you about a locked door. Stone Toad. It preys on small creatures, meaning if you turn into Morph Ball, it'll try to eat you. Incinerator drone, programmed for high temperature waste disposal. Device schematics indicate a high risk of malfunction when internal power core is damaged. Unit has minimal combat programming but can defend itself if necessary. This drone's intense heat blast compensate for its lack of battle prowess. Barbed war wasp, airborne insect with the ability to launch its stinger at prey. A highly aggressive member of the war wasp family, this insect can propel the tip of its stinger up to 20 meters. The stinger tips regrow seconds after launch, contain an acidic compound designed to pre-digest prey. Thank you. Nerf ball bomb. An okay upgrade, but it becomes annoying very quickly. Why? Because you gotta learn to do this. Set a bomb, set a bomb, set a bomb. Jump higher. You gotta learn how to do that. So you set it, set, 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 set. You have to learn to do that correctly. And see how I didn't do it? Means I'm gonna be in trouble when that comes around. Probably because my video is like 500 milliseconds behind whatever input I put into it. The video and the audio are correct, but what I'm seeing is like 500 milliseconds less because of the video capture software. Yum yums. I'm supposed to go up here real quick. I forgot. Ah! Stop it. I like Spider Ball. It's awesome. hoping. Of the poison, Flagara, something like that. Activate all four runes. Yep. One that can actually hurt you. plant is the source of toxic water in the ruins. Flagler's growth cycle has been radically accelerated. As a result, it requires new constant exposure to solar energy to remain active. This exposure has made Flagler's outer shell thick and durable. Its lower root system is unprotected and vulnerable, however. Exploit this flaw when possible. Concentrated weapon fire can daze it for short periods. suit. Ultra energy. Pulse bamboo. They are energy beings. They are invulnerable to everything except for the wave beam. That's all you need to know. The world of living things feels strange to us. We who have existed so long on the edges of time and space, it is clear now that we Chozo can never return to our dimension, not while the great poison reaches ever further into the planet. It is so powerful, this creeping evil, that our wills are crumbling and our minds are beginning to fail. And so, before it is too late, we now make our last stand. We have begun to build a temple to contain this darkness. At its heart, we will place a cipher, a mystical lock powered by 12 artifacts, and filled with as much power as we Chozo can harness in our ethereal states. Even when we are done, it may be too late. Up there. Our sanctuary grows by the day. We chose to know much of technology, but we have chosen to leave it behind on this journey. Our home here on Talon 4 will be a place of simplicity. Structures hewn from the stone, bridges woven with branches, always caressed by pure waters. We build around the ancient and noble trees, drawing from their strength and giving them our own in return. All that is wild will flow around us here. Our race will be just one more group of creatures in the knit of nature. It is our hope that such a state will bring with it great wisdom, a greater understanding of the nature of the universe. Once our city here is complete, we will peer inward and discover the truth. It's just saying 1, 2, 3 locks. First, second, third, fourth. Here we go. I'm gonna do this one. This one's stupid. There we go. I got it. Better get used to that, and you better learn it. I like to save before I go to the next region. Not because I like to be honest, but because my game disc does not behave. So it does. It has a chance of freezing. If it freezes, I'll have to figure out what to do. Because I think it's progressively gotten worse on this game disc, and I might have to get a new game. So if it freezes, that's actually probably going to end gameplay of Metroid Prime 1 until I get a new game disc. Because I already know about this problem that I have with this game disc. I have a problem that when I go from one region to the next, they may not ever load. So if it doesn't load, that's the end of this playthrough. For now. Sorry. Not much I can do about it. Unless I want to play an emulation version, but I like playing on the actual system. Wait a second. Right, I need to go the other way. Later. Get this real quick. again, I'm not really sure if I can load the next region, so this... it might invalidate what I'm doing right now. Here we go. I hope it loads the region. If it doesn't, there's nothing I can do about this. It does nothing. Okay. Well, I made it this far. Try to make it to a save point. Check this out. Steam. I made it. Okay, cool. So I can continue this playthrough still. It's just an enemy that's like uses up your missile. But I mean, just walk around it. Awesome music. A magmor, fire-breathing serpent that dwells in lava. Just a gas filled something that you just explode. These things are annoying though. I don't like them. Because you gotta explode them and you gotta wait. They actually can hurt you pretty badly for some reason. Triclops. It'll grab you when you're a morph ball. Like, the room is set up to where you have to be a morph ball. Now, listen to this. When the Triclops grabs me, it does a pluh sound. An audible pluh. You hear that? Isn't that weird? Back to this region later, I just need to make my way through. there are space pirates still on the planet. They're just not showing up yet because it's supposed to be like they're out doing what they're doing, you know, at the moment, getting phase on and dealing with the cradle. And they haven't detected that Samus is legitimately there. They were dealing with the parasite on the ship, so they didn't have time to report that the hunter has arrived. Other than, Ripley. Ripley knows the hunter is there. So it kind of comes down. It's supposed to be kind of like time-based. You'll see. They'll figure out you're there, and then that's when all hell breaks loose. You start having to deal with all the wildlife and the pirates at the same time. Technically, the pirates are supposed to be smart. Like, they're not really that much of a threat in most regards. But they do stuff that kind of shows that they're a bit intelligent. Actually difficult to do. Oh, problem is I gotta hope that the game loads. Here we go again. Like it so far. Okay, now I gotta get to a save point, because that was actually a crucial moment that I needed to get past for this game to legitimately work. This is actually my favorite music inside the game. Well, one of my favorite. Finjana Drifts. It kind of tells you, like, the materials or something, minerals, that you have to get past. And you gotta recognize, like, which weapon gets past those minerals. Now you're actually entering where space pirates are very active. New personnel must report to the South Research Facility. Failure to report will be penalized by a 30% ration cut and extra duty. Western Temple is in phase 2 lockdown. All projects are postponed. Under no circumstances are personnel to attempt access. All ballistics support personnel report to research lab Hydra. Lockdown containment plan 3A is in effect until further notice. Cool. So, what I need to do is I need to get in there. And this thing right here opens up the way, believe it or not. Scatter bamboo. It's just like the other bamboo, only wave. What was it? Wave gun? Wave beam? Can hurt it. They don't really hurt you all that bad, so don't worry, just go right through it. Oh yeah, they do mess up your monitor, don't they? Here's one of the first kind of annoying, tough enemies. A baby Shegoth. Time to tango with this thing. Need spider ball, I think. Yeah, let's see. All right. Come out of there. Ice Shriek Bat. Not in the PAL version, but the NTSC versions of the game. This is a one-time only kind of deal, so you gotta get these Ice Shriek Bats. They do the same thing as other Shriek Bats, but it's a special scam. Super special. Bip. Yeah. Well, you're dead. Come on, boy. Come on. Come on. I guess they're not in this game, but... None know if our temple, the Cradle, will prove powerful enough to contain this evil forever. How can we, Chozo, hope for it to remain intact when that which it guards writhes in the darkness, growing always stronger? The fate of this world rests with the gathering of artifacts we call the Cipher, but even it is not all-powerful. It is strong. Yes, an enchanted hole made of 12 links. Still, it is finite. Finite in its reach, and we who guard it are slowly succumbing. When our vigilance crumbles away into madness, the cipher will be exposed, and the fate of Talon IV will be beyond our influence. Many Chozo have gone beyond now, and this is a mercy. Those of us who remain suffer in dimensional flux, drifting helplessly across time and space, guided by unseen and inexorable currents. The Chozo who cling to sanity fight the tide, but our minds are weakening. Soon we will all be like the turned Chozo who have been utterly corrupted by the great poison. The turned still hold to their Chozo forms, but their minds are black with fell intentions. Gone is their respect for life. They honor only destruction and seek to disrupt the artifacts holding the great poison at bay. All life taunts them, and they do not rest. Before long, they will be all that remain of the Chozo here. she just bite me? Freak. Miss. Propulsion units used to make platforms float are insufficient to support full bodysuit weight indefinitely. Dun dun dun. Boost ball. It's showing you that it's a ramp. It's a half pipe. Better get used to that. There's a lot of half pipes in here. It's fun. Gotta knock that off after a while, though. Guess what you gotta do. Go all the way back to Talon Overworld. Just for a stupid half-pipe. Can you believe that? Fight me! Fight me! Thank you. Alright. Let's head back. Did I save? I don't remember if I saved or not. I better save after all that. Let's try going through here. I don't remember where this actually leads. That's Chozo. It's back to Talon Overworld. Nope. That's not a place I can go in. Damn it. Please don't freeze. It hides it under the bridge. You don't have to fight them. It's a nest. It's actually an improved version of the Zoomer, I think. I can't remember what the other one's called. Gamer. A Zoomer and a Gamer. I don't know. Oh, Zoomer. Why didn't you have it as... Why didn't you just have Zoomer and Gamer? That'd be cool. Bloodflower. A toxic plant that tries to puke on you. That's all plants do in nature. Blow up its puke before it gets to you, and then it burns itself alive on its own puke. Talon 4 is a very strange world. Here's the half-pipe it's talking about. Sandstone. Sandstone is destroyed by the morph ball bombs. Double jump. Go back here real quick. Get something. There we go. The neat thing is, from this point forward, you start getting some really neat equipment. It just gets better and better. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. I want to thank you for watching. Hope you have yourself a good day. This is Sweet Tooth, signing off. Love you.